Hey guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome to a game called Kynseed. I have been following the development of this game for quite some time now, and I am so excited to finally give it a try. It was just released as an early access title over on Steam a few days ago, but just in case you've never heard of Kynseed before, it's kind of like games like Stardew Valley. We're going to be dropped in a small little town, we'll have to build a home for ourselves, we can go farming, we can make a shop. We can even go adventuring too. But the place where this game really shines is that our characters can actually age. So eventually our characters will get old and pass away, but if we have children, we can choose to carry on the game through them. So we can literally build the family tree like generation after generation, and that just sounds so fascinating to me. So I'm super excited to start a new game with you guys, and it looks like we have two characters to choose from. Either a boy or a girl. So we're gonna go ahead with the girl here. Oh, and it looks like we're jumping straight into the story too, okay. There was an old woman who lived in a shoe. She had so many kids, she didn't know what to do. Then one day a man without wife or child came to the house with manner so mild. The man looked at the orphans and stroked at his chin, then smiled at two children, each one a fair twin. He took them away to live in the Vale, in the land of Quill, the place of our tale. Then they slept safe, warm, and dry under the watchful stars in the sky. Oh, so it sounds like this is where our story begins. I guess we were one of the children with the old woman in the shoe. And this old man came and adopted us and brought us to a place called the Vale. It looks like somebody really wants you to wake up, little one. Maybe that's the old man, our new father. Oh, but look at this place. Oh, the art style in this game is just gorgeous. Look at all these flowers. Oh, and is this our brother up here? Our twin. So he adopted both of us? Faring well. Come talk to me, hold the right mouse button, and choose the chat option. Okay, so it must be this right here. Come on, lazy bones. Our new dad has been kind to us, and we should be earning our keep not having a sleep. Here's your task list. Push C to view it. Okay, that sounds easy enough. It sounds like he's already putting us straight to work. Oh my goodness. Wait a second, are these all of our tasks? Oh my gosh, pick dandelions, make an offering, feed pigs, and harvest carrots. Wow, we have a lot of work to do already. Oh, and it looks like this might be us. So our name is Robyn, and we're 12 years old. Excellent. But which one of these tasks are we supposed to do first? Is it maybe pick a dandelion? Let's see if our sibling knows any more about it. Father wants you to feed the pigs. An apple should do. Shake one down from a tree and collect it with the right mouse button. Throw something by left mouse button or choose feed from the interaction menu. You won't earn any pocket money if you don't do as you're told, so get a move on. Off you go then, hold shift to run, so chop chop. You can toggle always run in the options menu. Alright, so kind of like Stardew Valley. So the first task we have to complete is feeding the pigs. Okay, and it sounds like we have to go find some apples, but something tells me it's probably not just any tree. Surely there are some apple trees out here somewhere. Maybe if we follow our brother? There we go. It didn't give our brother a name, though. I wonder what his name is? But here's our first apple. An apple a day keeps the doctor away. Just throw them at him. Yeah, that's exactly what that means. Excellent. I don't think I mentioned that this game was actually made by some of the same people from Lionhead Studios, so they put together the Fable games in the past. You can definitely see some of the same humor shining through. Why are some of these apples purple, though? It looks like they're all red when they go into our inventory, unless those are getting tucked away inside our backpack. Just the one pair, not both of them, just the one. Yeah, let's see if there's any difference. Potential traits? Ooh, that's mysterious. I don't know, maybe it's something that we'll learn later. Right now, we just need to focus on finding enough apples for the pigs, and then I guess focus on actually finding the pigs too. I wonder if our brother went off that way as well, or if he has some different jobs to do around this place. It seems like this old man brought us to some sort of farm. Oh my gosh, and he has a cow. Oh, how adorable is this? We can pet the cow too. Oh my gosh, you are so cute. We can even give you one of the apples. Well, these were meant for the pigs, but she seems to enjoy the apples as well. Now, is this the old man? Can we talk to you too? Yeah, father. Good to have you around. Must be much better out in the open air than spending all that time in a big sweaty shoe. I won't lie, my health hasn't been great, and so I need the help, and I will reward you for every task. I left a load of signposts around the farm to help you. Use left control to read them. Well, that's very kind of you. He has signposts around here. There they are. These little signposts with the eyes next to them. Use the left trigger to view status of objects. Oh, are these the fields? Maybe, yeah, this is where we could find, like, the carrots and the cabbages. There they are. Might as well harvest these since we're here anyways. Exotic, exciting, succulent, three words that you can't use to describe a cabbage. Yeah, I wouldn't normally consider cabbages to be too exciting. Oh, but it looks like we have a watering can now too. Basically, a shower for plants and flowers. So if these need to be watered, at least we could do that. Great for helping you see in the dark by setting them on fire. Nice. I don't think we read the signpost yet. Look at the status of crops to see if they need watering or are ripe. Yeah, but we don't have any other crops in here. At least we have a couple more apples that we can pick. But I still haven't seen the pigs yet. Maybe we do have to go hunt down our brother. Maybe he can point us in the right direction. There's another sign over here, though. Let's take a look at this, too. Welcome to Messages from the Great Creator. Read these signs to find out much more about the future of Quill. So that must be from the developers, perhaps? Maybe they'll give us some hints about what's to come? I'm surprised that our brother isn't around here, though. He wandered off pretty far. Oh, there's the pigs. Oh, I must have missed you before. It looks like we have a little wooden bucket. Never drink from this. Is there something nefarious inside? Use a wooden bucket to scoop up the poo. Coming soon. Oh, geez. All right. So we don't want to use this to get any drinking water. Understood. So we've got to feed the pig. Our brother said that we could just throw it inside, I think. Let's see if we can toss it in for our little piggy friend. There we go. Completed task. Feed one pig. Oh, but I want to know if I can pet you, too, just like the cow over by father. Wait, we can ride the pig? Really? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, we can actually ride the pig around the farm? That is too adorable. Oh no, but he can't come out of his pen? That's probably for the best, to be honest. Here, can we get off of him, though? There we go. Gotta press the tab key to get off of the pig. Now, is this to pet him? Maybe? It looks like we're gaining a little bit of relationship with the pig at least. Or is he following us? Oh, I think that may have been the follow command. I get it. Little pig? Okay, I thought you couldn't leave your pen, but apparently you can. You have proven me wrong. So we finished a couple more quests? And it looks like there's some fruit over here too. We might as well pick these up since we're here. I'm sure we'll need fresh blueberries at some point. And then the ones down here look like they might be strawberries. Forever in fields full of beetles. Strawberry fields forever. Now where is that brother of ours? Maybe now that we've completed our task, he'll tell us what to do next. Ooh, looks like there's... Is that a beehive up here? Can we interact with the beehive? Oh, we collected some honey with the wooden bucket? Oh. Oh no, are the bees following us now? Oh, I hope they're not going to hurt us. Oh, they follow us when we have the honey in our hands. Interesting. I wonder if there's a way for us to lead the bees somewhere else. That's something that we're going to have to keep in mind. Yeah, we can collect honey if we have the right container. So I guess the wooden bucket works just fine. Now, what else did we have to do today? Pick a dandelion. The future. The polar ice caps have melted. Apes run amok with machine guns. People solve murders before they happen by looking at their little balls. And the people of Quill tell the time by picking dandelions. Nature is the best technology. They tell the time by picking dandelions? What does that mean? Well, it's getting pretty late now, so we could probably use that. Do you think maybe we could just pick the flowers then? Is this a dandelion? There we go. And it gave us a little clock in the corner. All right, so that must be what they meant by telling time. Very, very interesting. It looks like the day is definitely almost done. So we picked our dandelions, we harvested our crops, and we fed the pigs. Now we need to make an offering. The brownies are mischievous fae sprites who love human food as much as they love playing pranks. With the right offering, they might even help out. Use the large offering bowl outside your house and gift them an item. Do not forget to do so, though. Oh, and let me guess, if we forget, they are probably going to be playing some pretty nasty pranks on us. So we have to look for the offering bowl right outside the house. But after that, we need to fill the water trough. Not to be mistaken for fill the trough, a Poppy Hill farmer who had a long body and drank nothing but water. Just get a tin bucket and use it on a fresh water source. Then hold the bucket and pour it into the trough. Alright, that sounds pretty easy too. But we do have to hunt down this tin bucket because right now we only have the wooden bucket and it's kind of full of honey at the moment. Our pig is probably not going to appreciate it if we give them honey instead of water. Maybe there's something inside the house? This must be the wooden bowl. So what should we put inside? I guess maybe we could do one of the apples? We have so many of these. Did it go inside? Oh, there we go. Present our offering. So hopefully the brownies, I think they were called. Hopefully they're going to enjoy our gift. Oh, excellent. We have a lantern now too. Just in time for the darkness. Oh no, poor Robyn is feeling sleepy already. We haven't found the tin bucket yet. Oh, I hope he's not going to be too upset if we don't finish all of our chores for the day. Can we perhaps light our lantern? There we go, so we can see a little bit more easily because... Oh no! Otherwise, I have no idea how we're going to find it. Oh, poor Robyn. Isn't that typical? We always seem to pass out on the very first day in these games. Well, day two. Weather is expected to mostly be sunny with a 0% chance of rain. All right. We have four brass waiting to be collected as well. So, I'm assuming that's probably from our father. Come on, get up. More to do today. I couldn't stay awake last night. Father told me that the fae sprinkle children with sleeping dust so they don't see their midnight dances. Maybe that's why he was in bed so early. And this is our payment from the day before. Excellent. Four brass for completing four different rewards. So it said something about getting more quests. Yeah, here they all are, but none of them are new. We actually have to pick a dandelion again, and hopefully this time we can actually fill the water trough too. We're gonna try our best to find that tin can. He might have a quest for us. It looks like he has something to say. Another busy day. I hear you are going to the village. Don't get too distracted. We get to go to the village today. Here's two brass. We need a new tin bucket from the village. Oh, we don't even have one. I open the south and west gates. I trust you to be careful out there. The Vale is a haven, but always keep the path in mind. It's always safe to follow the path. Once out of the farm, follow the signs and head west to the village. Might help to say hello to some of the folks out there, too. Nice, so we're going to meet some of the townsfolk. Of course, I've already forgotten which way he said to go. I think he said he opened the gates in the west, so maybe we should go this way. They all have those exclamation points over their head, though. Is there more for them to tell us? I like our new dad. Let's make him proud. He said if we do well, we might even get a birthday present at the end of the season. Our first ever. Oh, that is adorable. So I guess if they have more to say, then they have that exclamation point. But I'm not seeing where we can go to the town. Maybe we have to follow it all the way down to the south? Pretty sure he also said that he opened the southern gates. There we go. So mind the path. I guess if we stray from the path, there's probably always a chance we could run into danger. Ooh, and our first person. Hello. Let's introduce ourselves. A wanderer. Hello, youngin. I'm just resting here while the missus prays. Then we head back to Poppy Hill. As a kid, you won't have been out of this here Vale, would you now? When you come of age, the wonders of the land will be all yours. Wish I was young again. Alrighty, so this must be his wife over here. And she's praying to the statue of some sort? Maybe she'll tell us a little bit more about it. Wanderess. You interrupted my blessings. Don't you know what this is? This is a goddess statue. You can pray here to our beloved fae goddesses and give an offering. If they like your gift, you might even be blessed by their touch. Just interact, then choose the goddess you wish to offer to, and then the gift. You Vale folk worship Druida, goddess of the orchards. So if you want your apples to be free of worms, best be careful what you offer. Ooh, interesting. So if we don't give a very good gift, it sounds like these goddesses could potentially curse us. Well, I'm not really sure which goddess this is. I don't see it telling us a name anywhere. And it doesn't look like we can give them apples either. Just all of these other items that we've gathered up. So should we give it a try? Maybe give it one of our strawberries? That was a promising sound. I think it liked it. I'm liking the looks of that. I'm going to assume that we did the right thing there. So let's continue on to the west, and hopefully this will take us toward the village. This looks like it could be the right way. There's a lot of banners around here anyways. Is this the village that we're looking for? The Candle Witch Village? All right. So I guess we just need to find some sort of shop. Somewhere where they might be selling. What is that? Ooh, that doesn't look like the right place to find any tin buckets, but I wouldn't mind stopping to watch the show. How do we get in there? Maybe the door was up here toward the north, and we're passing by all these people, too. We passed by you first, so what's your name, sir? Toby Jug. Hello, youngin. Heard you were up at Willowdown. I own the tavern with my wonderful daughter. We don't serve minors, but we do serve minors. Not that there are any left. My Melanie is in charge. She is just so much better at business. I wonder if that was his daughter then that we saw walking past. Maybe if we scoot on inside to watch the show, we can meet her too. What kind of show is this? Oh, I love those masks. Something tells me the father would not be too happy that we're getting so distracted. I don't think we're going to find our tin buckets here. So let's see if there are any shops around the area. The Cuckoo Wood is north. Not exactly what we're looking for. That looks like it could be a shop of some sort. I'm just going to go ahead and steal their strawberries in the back, though. We might as well take that, too. Is this maybe a blacksmith? See, it looks like they have some sort of blacksmith on the side. But this guy might be selling something. Jeffrey Black. Well, hey and ho, and away we go. We'd heard about old Misery Guts adopting a couple of whippersnappers. Oh, ignore me, I'm just being a silly billy. It's lovely to see a fresh face around here. There is more life in the ancient burial grounds than there is in this village. If you need anything making, ask Jeremy. He provides all the power. I'm just the face of the business, although quite a cute face, I think you'd agree. Alright, but do you have any tin buckets? That's really all that we need. We have a lantern focus, arguments, shade wards, and spades. No, sir, it doesn't look like you have what we need at all. Maybe the shop over here? I see somebody in the window. That one looks a little bit more promising. Ooh, and this one too. Oh, look at all the items in here. It looks like there's decorations, candy, hairs, a rose of romance. Is that a dog? Oh, sniff the dog. Oh my gosh, it's only 10 brass. Can we buy a puppy? Oh, imagine if we came home with a dog instead. Our dad would never let us go into the village again. Oh, I think I see the bucket up here. But let's talk to him first so we can get to know him. Ichabod Moon. Welcome to the Vale. I am not from these parts originally, but I decided to corner a hole in the market. Once I had filled the hole, I built a stall and eventually worked my way to where I am today, which is here. Alright, well you have a very interesting shop, I must say. I am really, really tempted to buy that dog as soon as we have enough brass. There's our tin bucket though. Let's go ahead and buy this. For carrying liquids, the drinkable variety. So now we should be able to finally give our pig the water that it needs. And have we talked to you before? Looks like you're here to shop. Oh, there's nothing that we can tell her? Okay, so some people don't really have very much to say, it seems. In fact, I'm not sure if anybody here is going to have much to say at all. I guess we just want to focus on the people who have the exclamation points over their heads. And why do we have like a flashlight coming out of our face? Do we still have our lantern on? Yes, that is exactly the problem. Don't want to waste all that good lantern juice, Robyn. Not when we're saving up for a puppy. Alright, so back to the home. Hopefully we'll have enough time to actually give the pigs the water. And then I think we still need to pick another dandelion, right? Is that one right there? I think it might be. There we go. Pick a dandelion. Task complete. So I noticed that sometimes the clock is still up in the corner, but sometimes it seems to disappear. So I don't know if it's helping picking them every day, but we might as well grab them when we see them. Now I think we're going to have to pull the tin bucket out of our inventory. It must be in our equipment. There we go, the tin bucket. Let's swap that out with the wooden bucket that we had before, since we can't really use that to collect any water. Yeah, the trough must be right inside the pig's pen. So let's go ahead and grab some water. Excellent. Task complete, finally, little one. And we'll go ahead and feed you too. There you go. Sorry that it's so late. So we picked the dandelion, we fed the pig, we gave the pig water. Now all that's left to do is to make an offering, and then we will have successfully completed every last one of our quests today. So I think the apple worked pretty well. We'll go ahead and pop that into the bowl today too. And we might as well talk to our father before we go to bed, just to let him know that we actually grabbed the tin. Oh my goodness, and our little flashlight is still beaming from our face. Well done. You can use that bucket for a bunch of purposes. Go try it out. That thing will store more than just plain old water. Excellent, so it's getting pretty late. Let's go ahead and tuck ourselves into bed this time. Oh, so we can actually choose how long we want to sleep. All right. So 3 hours would reset this entirely, but since it's so late, it seems like no matter what we choose, we're going to end up sleeping until the next day. So 3 hours should do. Oh, Robyn, that is no way to sleep. Did you see that? She fell out of bed. So day 3, weather is expected to mostly be sunny with a 10% chance of rain. And of course, we have our 3 brass to collect for doing all of those chores. Well, this game is super cute so far. Oh, and Father is still sleeping. The kids are awake before Father. I'm not sure if he's going to have anything to say. Our sibling doesn't have a name either. That's kind of sad. Looks like Father might have a new quest for us after all. Let's see what he has to say today. We need to start planting the seeds. You can buy seeds from the goods market on the festival green to the south of the village center. The market is on there every 3rd and 10th day of the season. Here's 3 brass to go get some seeds. Okay, so if we want seeds, we're going to have to remember those dates, I guess. Before we go this time, though, let's go ahead and fill our offering. It seems like those tasks repeat every single day. We'll want to, of course, offer up one of these apples to the pig. And I think its trough is still full. Do we not have to do that today? Oh, excellent. Okay, so we just have to feed the pigs and then go buy seeds from the market. Go to the market or find a traveling trader and buy seeds. They come in packs of 4 like wolves, although wolves are extinct, so there's no proof of that. Oh no, wolves are extinct in this world. Well, that's a bummer. But at least we can still buy ourselves an adorable little puppy. Do not tell Father, though. That is going to be our little secret. We're not even telling our own brother about this one. So it doesn't seem like there's anything left for us to do out here. And the pig isn't too interested in his food. Well, if he hasn't eaten that apple by the time we get back, then we'll see if we can, like, hand feed it to him. We should probably make sure that we're replenishing our stock of apples as well. And I still don't understand why some of these apples are purple. Do you think it means that they're lesser quality? That statue did say that it could potentially curse our apples with worms. I hope that's not what we're feeding the pig. I guess that would explain why he doesn't really want to eat them. But I thought the statue was happy with our gift. Oh, and it's raining now too. That 10% little chance of rain. Well, it looks like the lights may have gone off. And I still don't really see a name to the statue. So let's try something different this time. I believe we gave them strawberries last time. Let's go with a good old pear this time instead. Maybe now you'll be a little bit happier and you'll bless our crops. Now we're looking for the good shop this time. I guess it's going to be something that we didn't see before because it's only supposed to be open on the 3rd and the 10th. So let's see if we can figure out where it might be. Oh, a chicken. Oh, can we interact with you too? Oh, we can give you a nice little pat on the head. We could offer up some apples too, but I'm not sure if a chicken is going to enjoy that. Oh, how adorable. I wonder if we can have our very own chicken on the farm as well. This was the girl who was following that guy before. I want to know if maybe she was his daughter. Melanie Jug. Welcome to our village. I'm Toby's daughter and owner of the Flailing Arms. Can't serve you, I'm afraid, but come of age and I will happily fill your tankard. Well, it's nice to get to know you anyways. Oh, and it looks like they have a new performer up here for the day. Well, that's a lovely song. Much more peaceful than the last one. Now, before I got distracted by the chicken, I was going to say that Father told us it should be south of the center of town, which I'm going to assume is probably this right here. So we want to go directly south, and hopefully that's going to lead us to the shop. And it takes us right past this one too with the puppy. Oh, my heart. It was only 10 brass. I mean, we have 10 brass. We do have 10 brass. But seeds first. Gotta show Father we're responsible. Oh, this place is like a full-on festival. Okay. I thought we were just looking for a shop. It looks like this is where we can buy the seeds, though. We can get cabbage seeds here. It's for 1 brass each. Yeah, this is what I was afraid of. So let's go ahead and buy some cabbage seeds. I guess we only had to buy 1 pack. But what do you have way over here? That looks different. Some wheat seeds, okay. I'm guessing that certain seeds probably grow during certain seasons, so we'll have to keep that in mind too. And we have a signpost to read over here. You can use this market stall to sell items. Shoppers may want to barter with you, so try and hit the green area if they do. So if we wanted to open up our own shop, we could actually come and do so right over here. We could open an apple shop with all the apples that we have inside our bag. Ooh, what is this? Ooh, is this some sort of ritual, maybe? I wonder what they do with that thing. It looks like this lady is selling wheat, too. I can't see the wheat on her stall, but it does say that she's selling it. And there's something way over here as well. Oh, the throwing minigame. We have 5 objects to throw. Hit targets for points. Hitting the center and smaller targets are worth more. A green center gives an extra throw. All right. So we can actually win prizes here at the festival too? Let's see if we can get at least 1 of these in. There we go, that was pretty good. It said that these green ones are going to be worth more. Nice. Oh, can we get it all the way back there? That one's pretty far away. Ooh, that was a perfect toss. Oh, you are on a roll, Robyn. Come on over here and try to get this one as well. Excellent. I wonder how many points we have to get for a prize. Here we go, we scored 510, and we've unlocked some sort of prize from it. So, what did we get? Did it pop up in our inventory anywhere? Well, I'm not seeing it inside here. Maybe we have to, oh, there we go. Come over here to collect it. Oh, what are these, a magic bean? Can take you to heights undreamed of. Oh my goodness, at least we didn't have to give away like our cow for it. And a rain stick too. Shake it to make it. Nice. So the only thing we didn't get is whatever is on this box right here. I guess we have to improve our throwing game if we want to unlock that too. But oh my gosh, it's already getting late again. Here we are getting distracted once again by all of the fun in the festival. Father is not going to allow us to go back into town at this rate. Let's rush back home. So did our little piggy eat his apple? Oh, looks like he's still not interested. Well, let's go ahead and pick this up, and we'll actually feed it to him this time. If we can find the apple in our menu, there we go. I guess he was just feeling a little bit lazy today. But that should be everything complete, right? We got the seeds and everything. So let's make sure that we turn in that quest to Father. There he is. Waiting inside, of course. No need to be out in the rain. Well done. Now go plant them in the soil patches. I'm pretty sure I know where that is, but it is getting kind of late, Father. Hopefully we're not going to end up passing out here. Let's plop that into our inventory. Maybe we should see if there's some way for us to put all these crops away, too. Like, there's probably no use in us just carting them around like this. Did we do that right? I think. Yeah, that plants the seed. Oh no, we're feeling sleepy now. Well, at least we got everything into the ground. I'm not really sure what all of those bars are. Oh, did we not put the last one in? There we go. It looks like all of them are there now. Yeah, let's go to bed. It is getting very, very late, and I think our poor little Robyn is just about to pass out again. So, I don't know. I'm liking this game so far. It has a particular charm to it, and I'm super excited to see what else we can discover as Robyn grows. Because the game is still in early access, I don't believe that aging has been added to the game yet. That's something that they're going to add in further updates. So let me know if that's something that you guys would like to explore too. Let me know if you want to see more of this game, because I would love to play more of it on this channel. But for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye guys!